MSB here, and it's time for another deck breakdown! Today's deck is a Sapphire and Ruby deck I call Cerebral Ascendance. I have always loved cards like Cerebral Fulmination, as they are both tricky to build around, and speed up gameplay significantly. The main issue when using cards like this is that since your opponent draws additional cards too, you have to make sure your deck can either shut down those extra cards, or that your cards synergize better with the extra draw. So let's take a look at what's in this deck. On the Sapphire side, we have 2 Birds of Plenty, 3 Counter Magics, 4 Incantation of Ascendances, 2 Mastery of Times, 4 Time Ripples, and 2 Twisted Fates. On the Ruby side, we have 4 Rage Fires, 4 Burns, 4 Cerebral Fulminations, 4 Heat Waves, and 4 Reginald Lancashires. For resources, we have 8 Sapphire Shards, 11 Ruby Shards, and 4 Shards of Fate. The champion I've chosen is Wyatt the Sapper, as the additional card you draw can get an incantation popped one turn earlier. Well, that and drawing an extra card is never really a bad thing. This deck is very versatile and has a heap of win conditions. You can drop an early incantation of Ascendance and pop a huge flying troop to smash face. You can get a Reginald Lancashire out and burn away early troops, allowing Reggie to infiltrate and set up us the bomb. You can also charge up massive Rage Fires and blast away with direct damage. Or, you can play a Bird of Plenty and Twisted Fate and watch as the extra card draw quickly decks out your opponent. Each of these win conditions synergize extremely well with Cerebral Fulmination and ensures you take advantage of the extra card draw better. Now that it's ready, let's go ahead and take it for a spin. Okay. Gazog. I will draw first. I don't mind playing second. With this. Double Reginald Lancashire. Whoa! Look at this ridiculous hand. Look at this ridiculous hand. Cool. I am definitely going to draw again. Horrible! Let's see. Okay, looking good. Okay, that's looking good. I'll keep it. It's not looking great. I do have to pull more resources, but at least I've got a burn to kill something early, if necessary. Since this is drawing a card, I mean, it could be like Replicator's Gambits on Darkspire Priestesses or something crazy. We'll see. Okay, cool. That was exactly what I wanted, was my second Ruby Shard, so I could throw out a Cerebral Fulmination and say, please, draw more cards with me. Let's have fun together. Okay, and Ruby. What you got? 2. Nothing. Okay. So, Blood Ruby could be direct damage. Could be Orc Rush, but he would have had something out on turn 2, for sure. Well, you know what? Let's just Cerebrally Fulminate. Let's both draw more cards. And be happy together. Yep. He doesn't have any sort of board presence. I've got Rage Fire and Burn. So, you know, I'll be able to kill a vampire if it comes out on turn 4. Veteran Gladiator is fine. Maybe it is an orc deck. Maybe it is an orc deck. I don't know. So far, all I have to do is draw a Heat Wave, and then I won't really care. Yep. Oh, another Cerebral. Time Roll? Hey. One card was good. Let's do 2! I love this! Yep. And then, you know, like I said, I can always just burn something away if necessary. If, you know, next turn is a Vampire King, that's fine. We need another, blood resource, but yeah, there's 3 cards, buddy. Okay, blood in 2. Another veteran gladiator. Okay. I don't mind going down to 17. More than likely what I'll do is I'll burn one of them away, I guess, next turn. Proceed to end. Yep, I'll burn one away. I mean, he could have burns to the ground and life drain, so I can't really let my health dip too low. That would be a mistake. One, two, there's E-Wave. Three, okay. Now we incantation. And have a good time. And it'll be up and running in two turns. He could have Relentless Corruption. He could have I don't know. I mean, you could still be an orc deck. Here, have three cards. Let's see what you do with them. Up to five. Endbringer. Throat Cutter. Okay. I'll probably Heat Wave next turn. Yeah, I'll definitely Heat Wave next turn. Because this will do 4 damage to me. I'll be down to 13. Yep. Totally cool. Yep. Deal that. Proceed. Proceed. On your way to oblivion. Here we go. Another Reach Fire. And a Reginald. And another Ruby. Okay. So let's go ahead and Heat Wave. Resolve. Pow, pow, pow. Now, do I want to draw a card? Yeah, let's draw a card first, because it doesn't really matter. And if I drew, like, a counter magic, then I'd keep it. Nope. Okay. So then I will... Reginald. Good old Reggie. Now, here's where it gets scary, because between... Well, no, my incantation of Ascendance is going to be crazy. It's going to be crazy big. 2, 4, 6, 8. Is it just going to kill next turn? Because I'm going to draw 3 cards. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 18 plus a Reach Fire? Yeah, it'll be dead. Yes, actually, it will be dead. And this is the thing against, like Orc Rush. Even though you're giving them tons of cards, you've got Heat Wave to just wipe them out. And if you get into Incantation of Ascendance, then you're doing, 18 to 20 damage in one turn. So it just does not matter. That's perfectly fine. Go ahead. Yep. I will even block with this, because I'd like him to spend his mana on something ridiculous. That's fine. Of course he has something like that. I don't really care. I just want to make sure that all of his resources are gone. So he couldn't pull out something crazy like a murder. Much better to have this pop as a 16-16! and then just do 20 damage. Yeah, so, exactly. Much better for him to have spent that mana so I didn't have to worry about a murder. But there you go. It's just... You get an Incantation of Ascendance and a couple of Cerebral Fulminations, and it's like, oh my gosh, I just do 20 damage. I've got a 20-20 on the board. I guess that's game. Okay. The Kyodle that does... ready each troop. Interesting. We'll see. Good luck. Have fun. Okay, what do we got? 1, 2, 3. This is a solid hand. Got a Reginald, Heat Wave. I'll keep it. Time Ripple and do an incantation. That's pretty solid. Don't have a Cerebral Fulmination, but that's fine. That's fine. Pass. Let's pass that priority. Right to end phase. I will play a Ruby Sharp first in case I draw a cerebral Fulmination on my next draw step. Because that will be important to get out. Because I've got a lot of cards to sort of deal with any sort of escalating aggression. Likely escalating aggression. What do we got at 2? Puck. Okay. That's cool. Proceed. Okay. Is he gonna live the dream? Does he have like 8 million high cost cards in his hand? And he's like, I've got the combo! Oh my gosh, a third ascendance? what do I want? Yeah, okay. That's cool. Great. A third incantation of ascendance. Ascendices. Got them coming on my ears. Top 10 cards, and bam! It's on. It's on. Okay, 3. Could he... What is he gonna get? 2? For, the Jadam? Sure. Yep, that's fine. That's fine. Proceed to end, and then we will timer pull. No thanks. That costs 6 now. And I think, since I've kind of seen that he doesn't really have any low-cost cards in his hands, I'm gonna Heat Wave. Yeah, I can't mess around with this. All Shards of Fate, get a Sapphire, accept, and Heat Wave out. Yeah. I'm not gonna let this Puck sit around and pull everything into his hand. That's... or everything into the field. Sorry, buddy, you're gonna have to build up your resources to 6 naturally. Okay, the good news is next turn I can play an Incantation of Ascendance. Oh, cool. Okay. So he's got an Argus. Okay, and a diamond. The question is, next turn... do I play my Reginald? Or do I play my Incantation? I don't have anything rolling to really make Reginald do stuff yet. So I'll just wait. Incantation and wait. Yep. And there's Argus. He's like, hey, how's it going? Still here. What you got? At 5. So yeah, next turn I'm going to have to save a counter magic for that Jadam specifically. So I'm not going to be able to really play anything, to be honest. Cool. Sure, I'll play that out, and then I'll just chill on it. Yep, all good. Because if he has another resource, I gotta be able to counter magic. And I don't have anything that costs 2. And there's still that Argus. Herald of Doom. He is Doom Heralding away. Yep, 6. So here comes the Jadam, and I will happily counter magic that. Nope. No, thank you. Now, of course, he could, you know, bring out a plethora of other things, but that's all not really mattering that much. Okay, cool, Rage Fire. So yeah, I'll bring out a Reginald. Yep. And I've got a Rage Fire behind it. Get something small. I mean, he could light up anything. I mean, he could throw down another Jadam for all I know. Yep, down to 8. Big man. Crazed Squirrel Titan, huh? Unfortunate that I don't have a burn in hand. Yep. That's fine. very odd. And obviously hitting a pretty solid mana curve, resource curve, because he's gotten a resource every turn from just natural draw. So, oh well. What do we got? I'm getting crazy stuff. I will throw out my second incantation. And that's it. Because next turn is when I'm going to draw my card. Because I want to draw my card when I have full resources. Because what could happen, for example, is I could draw a Mastery of Time. Which would be crazy. Let's see if he draws a 7th resource. Nope, I have Creation. Okay. And he is out a Herald of Doom. Okay, that's fine. Yep, next turn he's going to light it up. That was a, yeah, great set of cards to get. Time Ripple would be good, because obviously that would make it relatively useless. Master of Time would be decent. Yep, let's see what we get. If anything, a burn. Okay. So the question then becomes whether I drop an Incantation of Ascendance. Yes. Okay. So what I'll do is I'm going to drop a third Incantation of Ascendance, resolve, and then I will draw a card. And that'll pop all three of them. Pow, 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 pow. Now I got 3 8-8s. He'll wipe one of them, and that's fine. He'll wipe two of them, actually. Tack, tack. Actually, yeah, he'll wipe two of them, but I can get him into kill range with this. Deal combat damage. Yeah, buddy. Pow! Look at that damage! It's pretty crazy. Suddenly I'm not really caring that I had those two. No, I'm not gonna play my cards, because I'd have to hit him with both. So he'll kill he'll wipe out two of my cards, which is fine. Because he'll pop it, and then he'll ready the troop, and then he'll pop another one. But then he'd have to be able to block with something that's flying. That's okay. Yep, then ready and block again. Okay. This is fascinating. This is a fascinating deck. Druzhklok, Soulwalker, Argus, Herald of Doom. I'm surprised he isn't readying his troops, because this is death. Yeah, you can do that damage. Oh, I guess it doesn't matter, because, I mean, then if he doesn't have another flyer, it's over, because I've got double lightning armadas. There you go. Okay, yep. That's cool, because he'd still have to drop a flyer. The Druze doesn't help him. Druze doesn't help him. You can kill off another one. If you don't have anything to untap, then it's over. Yeah! Triple Lightning Armada! See, now that's an armada. That is an armada. That's nice. Okay, and yeah, I'll proceed to attack, and that's it. Yeah, armadas can get pretty crazy. You know, even that, which was like sort of a suboptimal play with no real combos, you're just doing crazy damage, because you have 3 8-8s out. You know, being able to draw this card from the hero power just really strengthens up the deck. Like crazy. Yeah, I will attack. Let's see if he's got anything, because he doesn't have enough resources for like a repel or anything, so. And even if he did, then I could just burn to Rage Fire. Yep, good game. Excellent. So yeah, there we go. Lightning Armada, beat down.
Boom!
Excellent. Yeah, that really showcases the power of the hero power and why you choose this champion specifically, because you get that availability to pop an incantation of ascendance, and if you pop one, you pop them all. So, really nice. So, as you can tell, the Cerebral Ascendance deck can handle a wide variety of threats while pressing your opponent's defense on multiple fronts. Be sure to stay tuned to my channel for more Hex news, drafts, deck breakdowns, and giveaways. And while you're at it, please take the time to subscribe. As always, I'm MSB, wishing you good games and good times.